I beat them. I flippin' beat them. I did it. And the cheapest way I can think of. And here, I'll explain. Basically, I used the heroic brew of ultra invincibility, because it's practically what it does, makes you invincible, it makes you hit 10 times harder, and not, yeah. And then I just backed everyone else except for Chaos here, backed everyone else up, out of range, and in Chaos slaughtered them all by himself. Not even joking. I probably won't get into the heroic brew forever now. But I don't care right now. Let's go. You sneak up to the entrance of a huge, breathtakingly beautiful cavern. The glowing fungus reveals huge, shimmering clusters of crystals filling the air with rainbow something. What's more, the crystals vibrate. They're emitting a continuous soothing hum which calms your nerves and alleviates your exhaustion. However, you have little leisure time to enjoy the cavern, for someone has gotten here first. A large contingent of Empire troops have set up camp outside the cavern, basking in its beneficial effects. Of course, it might be in your power to reclaim this wondrous place for Avernum. Get them! This is probably a terrible idea. However, they're only soldiers and Empire archers. That's not as bad, to be honest. Really, the Empire archers are the people I have to worry about. No one else. We're gonna stop there. We're gonna flippin' give him a shield. There we go. Then we're gonna summon some help. I'm gonna shoot at the Empire Dervish. Even that shield just isn't quite enough. Alright, we will do another shield. That'll increase the amount of shield he gets. And now they're all flipping confused. Which is awesome, I must admit. It's really awesome. We will also make him a bit faster. Excellent. Plug him full of holes. See, the problem, you want to know what the real big issue with that last battle? The wizard. The wizard was the problem. No one else. Magic users are a real pain in this game. But everyone else I can handle. Proper spells and everything, you can handle just about anyone. Who is I need to hit? Spells don't really distinguish from friend and foe. Oh. So I don't need to hit anyone else. This spell's not going to last forever, though. That's the problem. Yeah, it didn't last forever. We'll go ahead and get rid of these guys. He's only confused, though. That's the problem. So we're going ahead and kill him, actually. We don't want him to live. blast him to bits. Yeah, he's still confused. He doesn't know what the heck is going on. He's like, why are you hitting me? What's going on? And then he dies. Because we have no mercy for soldiers of the Empire. Empire can suck it. Alright, well, what did we get here? A fine leather. I'll take it. It's fine. Sure. Plate mail. Woo-wee! I want plate mail. No, you will give me the plate mail. That will be mine. What am I wearing? I'm wearing bronze plate mail. It doesn't say what kind of plate mail. It's mine. I want the plate mail. I'm not passing down a chance for plate mail. He is going to be so well defended. It's going to be awesome. Steel arrows. Steel arrows. Javelins. Food. We can all use food. Steel longsword. Oh, take it. It's nice. Arrows. Arrows. Nice arrows. More nice arrows. Excellent. End it. Let's say before we keep going inside, I'm not suspecting danger, but you never know with some things. I hope my voice is coming through. It should still. You return to the cavern you have reclaimed. The remarkable crystal formations are still there, and so many of their soothing hum. Do you go in? Yeah, I explore. The crystals hum and vibrate when you enter, filling you with waves of exhilarating energy. The powerful magic makes every cell in your body vibrate. Soon you leave the cave before the feeling overwhelms you. Though you leave the healing energy behind you, some remains within you and you feel so much stronger. A place to save and to rest. And we just had to kill some Empire soldiers for it. Well, we lost a heroic brew, but we gained a beautiful location, which I wish the game could do justice. It's describing something that I can only imagine is gorgeous and something that the eyes could behold. And really, this game encourages you to use your imagination about things. Which, I don't mind that too much. However, we have some plate mail to identify. And I would like to know what it does. So, in order to identify this plate mail, we have to head down all the way back to the Tower of Magi in order to do so. After which, we'll go back up to Fort Novno, and things will be good. And I could have cut this out, but I just like, you know, I feel like walking. And it didn't take me 2 seconds to get here anyway. What's he been doing? What has he been doing? What do you think he's doing? Shh! Sorry, I just like making fun of the guards. So what is he doing? Hear about that guy at that time? He did that thing with the thing. Yeah, I know that thing about the thing and the time and the thing and the thing. Iron plate mail. Not bad, I must admit. It's better than bronze plate mail. And I got it now. That is too heavy. What are you wearing? You're wearing bronze plate mail. Alright, we'll give you the iron plate mail. Not the bronze, but the iron plate mail. Where did the iron plate mail go? Thought I had 2 sets. Or I only have the 1 set. He only had the 1 set, what am I saying? I replaced it. So now he's wearing iron plate mail, which blocks 1 to 16 damage. Pretty sweet, I must admit. Pretty sweet. Means we have a leftover set of a bronze plate mail we can just sell. Wait, no. Well, we wanted to give it to you, didn't we? That's why I was moving it around, because we had an extra set. Where did I put that extra set, anyway? Huh. Excuse me, I seem to have lost it. Just like me to lose things. Aha, bronze plate. Here you go. Put that on. Now you have bronze plate. 1 to 16 minus 2, still better than 1 to 12. So we just... Well, that was excellent. Let's do some trading. Alright, excellent, excellent, excellent. We've got... I forget what this does. Accuracy and damage in combat, that makes you just a... And there's a shielding charm. Okay. And there's the Ring of Illness, which you do not want to wear. Let's get rid of it. It's no good to us anyway. Longsword, we don't need that. What else do we not need? Oh, I like it. Oh, there's so many shiny things that I don't want to get rid of. Shiny things. I like shiny things. All right, well, shiny things aside, I think what we're going to do next is try to find those sliffs. What you want to bet they're near the water, though? They could... Oh, that ain't the right way. What are we doing going that way? So what you want to bet they're in the watery area? Because they're lizards. Lizards like water, don't you know? Lizards love water. It's been interesting running an all-human party. Usually on my games, I like to have at least one of the other races, but... you guys didn't... The people towards the beginning when I first started this LP... They chose not to. Like, they chose to, want all humans. Huh, refugee's place. Well, let's talk about it. There's a large stone fence blocking off the entrance to this cavern. It's guarded by a motley assortment of humans, Nephilim, and Sliths. Most of them have bows, and most of them have arrows already knocked. A young muscle woman walks out and motions you forward. She either wants to talk to you or bring you of arrow range. We'll talk. You walk forward nervously. Fortunately, you're not attacked. When you reach the woman, she introduces herself as Janice and explains who they are. The people in this cave are refugees from the Abyss, a large cave led to the west where people are too rowdy or too difficult even for Avernum were placed. The Abyss was taken over by the Empire. Many of its residents were killed, some were enslaved, and the rest fled to other parts of Avernum. Many came here to subsist and prepare to defend themselves when the end comes. You can come in, Janice says. We want to be good neighbors, but don't cause any trouble. We're tougher than we look. A gate in the fence is open so that you can pass. The guards give you dirty looks as you walk by. People in the Abyss are very distrustful by Avernites. Considering that Avernum put them there is understandable. Yeah, it's like... A group of brigands fresh from the Abyss walk up to you. One of their number, a large fellow with a stone eye, says, "You have to pay a toll to pass. 5 coins. Pay up." He's a smart fellow. The moment you draw your weapons, he realizes that he's dramatically outclassed, and he and his brigands run for their lives. Good. So the Abyss is where, Several huts have been built here by refugees from the Abyss. When the people see you coming, they walk inside and slam the door shut. After a few minutes of being ignored, you leave. This is likely the response you'll get from most of the people here. The Abyss was like a prison area for... Like, they have prisons, but if people got way too out of hand, they'd just throw them in a pit like they just the Empire did to them. Which seems kind of ironic, you know? There's a small crude stone hut here built against the wall of the cavern. When you approach, a man comes out and invites you inside. He introduces himself as Scab. Inside the cramped hut are all manner of thieves' tools, poisons, and other criminal accessories. He immediately sets about trying to sell them to you. You aren't surprised he's allowed to sell these tools here. Agents of Avernum such as you need them to fight the Empire. And people from the Abyss hate Avernites, but they hate the Empire even more. Scabbers from the Abyss. He doesn't like you, but business is business. He'll give you fair prices. Good, because we have a guy who's pretty good at these things. An assassin's dagger. 2 to 12 plus 4. This weapon does 2 to 12 plus 4 points of damage per hit, and the hit chance depends on your... This weapon constantly drips poison, which afflicts anything it hits. Huh. So I can do 2 to 20 plus 3, or 2 to 12 plus 4, and also poison. Yes, I hear you. I do want a piercing crystal. That's always useful. I will think about the assassin's dagger. You know it's shiny. I want it. Give it to me. I have the assassin's dagger. Whether I use it or not, I don't know. But that's the end of this episode. Well, we still haven't got those slips I said we would go get. We went everywhere else. And that's the nature of this game. You find something interesting and you just want to stop and look at it. But we did some things at least, and we're getting better and better for it. On the next episode, we'll go for the slips this time. Unless I get distracted again. But we'll see. See you guys later.